Hey guys, welcome to another quantitative aptitude tutorial. Today we will learn how to solve train aptitude problems. We will also learn problems on train, shortcuts and tricks. Finally, at the end of this video, I will tell you how to solve these problems, train problems, quickly with my own shortcut technique. So make sure that you watch this video completely and subscribe to my channel. Let's get started. Problems on trains. Okay, so first problem is two trains travel in opposite direction at 36 km per hour and 45 km per hour. A man sitting in slower train passes the faster train in 8 seconds. The length of the faster train is, we have four options. First option is 100 meters, second option is 120 meters, third option is 80 meters, and final option D is 180 meters. Okay, so let's take a look at the solution. First, we have the basic formulas. Okay, what are the basic formulas? Speed is equal to distance upon time. And the second basic formula we need is 1 kilometer per hour is equal to 5 by 18 meters per second. Now, how do we get this 1 kilometer per hour is equal to 5 by 18 meters per second? 1 kilometer means 1000 meters, and 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. So, when you keep 1000 divided by 3600, we get 5 by 18 meters per second. So that is how we get this 5 by 18. Most of the people will tell you just this, use this 5 by 18, but they don't tell you how this 5 by 18 comes. So this is how the 5 by 18 meters per second is used. Now let's assume train A be the faster one, okay, and train B be the slower one. Now therefore the speed of train A is equal to 45 km per hour. Why? Because we are told that there are two trains, which travel at 36 km per hour and 45 km per hour. The faster one is 45 km per hour. That's why speed of A we assume is 45 km per hour. Now 45 km per hour, how to convert it into meters per second? First thing, why do we need to convert it to meters per second? Because we are given the timing over here in seconds. So we need to convert this speed also into meters per second. So how do we do it? We just multiply 5 by 18 to this value, which is 45. So 45 into 5 by 18 meters per second, that comes to 12.5 meters per second. Now speed of train B we are assuming is equal to 36 km per hour. Why? Because it is the slower one. Now how to convert this into meters per second? It is again simple. Just multiply it with 5 by 18. Just 18 ones are 18, 2s are 36. So 2 into 5, that is equal to 10 meters per second. So this is how we get the speed of train B. Now relative speed of man sitting in train B. So what is relative speed? So relative speed is the speed at which the man sitting in train B is traveling relative to the first train. Okay, which will be 10 plus 12.5. Why? Because see, both the trains are traveling in opposite direction. So it means that they are moving towards each other. So the speed, relative speed of the man will be adding up by its own speed, that is the speed of train B plus the speed of the first train, which is train A, which is traveling towards the man. So it will add up. So what will be the speed of train A? 12.5 meters per second, and train B 10 meters. So when you add, you get the relative speed of the man as 22.5 meters per second. Now since both the trains are traveling in opposite direction, okay, now length of faster train is equal to speed upon time. Now what does length mean? Length means the distance. Since the man sitting, the train passing from the man will be the length of the train, full train. So that actually means that it is traveling that much distance. So what is the formula for distance? Distance is equal to speed upon time. How do we get this formula? It is simple. We have the formula of speed over here. Yes. Now speed is equal to distance upon time. So distance is equal to, just take this time and multiply over here to the speed. So we get distance is equal to speed into time. So we now know the speed of the man, relative speed, which is 22.5 meters per second. Yes. And we also know the time, which is 8 seconds it takes to travel or cover that much full length of the train A. Since we know both this value, we just multiply 22.5 into 8 seconds, and that's how we get the final answer, which is 180 meters. So correct answer is option D, 180 meters. So this is our first problem. Now second quantitative aptitude train problem is this one. Station A and station B are 110 kilometers apart on a straight line. One train starts from station A at 7 a.m. and travels towards B at 20 km per hour. So what is the data given to us? That train A or the train from station A starts at 7 a.m. and starts traveling at 20 km per hour speed. Okay. Now another train starts from station B and it starts at 8 a.m. and travels towards A at 25 km per hour speed. At what time will both the trains meet? There are four options given. Option A, 12 p.m., B, 9 a.m., C, 10:30 a.m. and D, which is 10 a.m. Okay. Now, solution is, first thing, we have the distance between two stations, which is 110 km. Speed of train A is 20 km per hour. Speed of train B is 25 km per hour. Now, let's call train starting from station A as train X and train starting from station B as train Y. Now train X starts at 7 a.m. and 20 km per hour speed. Train Y starts at 8 a.m. and 25 km per hour speed. Yes? So distance covered from 7 a.m. to 8 a.m. is 20 km. Why? Because at that time only train A or train X actually. Yeah, train X is moving. And at what speed? It is moving at 25 km per hour speed. So till 8 a.m. train B is not moving, train Y is not moving at all. So total distance covered will be 20 km. Now at 8 a.m. when train Y starts, okay, what happens is at 8 a.m. train Y also starts. So now both the trains are moving in opposite direction. Yes. And total distance remaining right now is 90 kilometers. Why? Because from 7 to 8 a.m. train X has already covered our 20 kilometer distance. So now total 90 kilometer distance is left. Okay. Now when both the trains are traveling towards each other, we know the relative speed adds up. Okay. So we have the total relative speed of 20 plus 25 kilometer per hour, which is equal to 45 kilometer per hour, as both trains are traveling in opposite direction. Now we know the formula for time. Time is equal to distance upon speed. So we now know the distance, that is 90 km. We also know the relative speed, which is 45 km per hour. So what we do, we just substitute to find the time. 90 km divided by 45 km per hour. So 45 and 45 2 are 90. Yes. Now time is equal to 2 hours after 8 a.m. So make sure that this is after 8 a.m. Okay. Why? Because this is the time, this is the distance remaining after 8 a.m. So don't get confused that the time is 2 hours, then you add up and it becomes 9 hours. No, it is after 8 a.m. Okay. So time is equal to 8 plus 2, which is 10 a.m. So option D is the correct option. That is that both the trains will meet at what time? 10 a.m. Okay. Now the next problem that we'll look at is this. A train X starts from station A at 4 p.m. and reaches station B at 5 p.m. while another train Y starts from station B and reaches station A by starting at 4 p.m. and reaches the station at 5:30 p.m. At what time will both trains meet? Okay, so what is happening over here is train X is starting from station A and reaching station B at 5 p.m. Okay, so it's starting at 4 p.m. reaching station B at 5 p.m. So it is taking total 1 hour, whereas train Y is starting from station B and reaching station A in 1.5 hours. Why? Because it is starting at 4 p.m. and reaching at 5:30 p.m. At what time will both the trains meet? There are four options given: 4:45 p.m., 4:36 p.m., 4:48 p.m. and 5 p.m. So what is given to us? Time taken by train X, 1 hour. Time taken by train Y to cover the same distance as train X is 1.5 hour. Okay. Now we are not given either the speed nor the distance. So what we are going to do, many people will tell you to use X. I am going to suggest you a better or simpler method. Okay. As I had mentioned, I am going to tell you my shortcut tricks. Okay. Now, so we can assume a distance and calculate the speed for our use. So how we'll do it? For the best or simplest one, we'll use the distance as 60 kilometers between two stations. Okay, now speed of train x according to our data then will be 60 kilometer per hour. Okay, because it is covering the distance in 1 hour. Yes, and for train y it will be 60 kilometer per 1.5 hour, which is 45 kilometer per hour. You divide 60 by 1.5, you get 40. So we have got the speeds now of train x and train y. We also have the distance, which is 60 kilometers. Now both train x and train y start at the same time, that is 4 p.m. in opposite direction. So the relative speed will be 60 plus 40, that is 100 kilometer per hour, because we just got both the speeds, right? 60 kilometer per hour and 40 kilometer per hour. So now relative speed, since they are traveling in opposite direction, will add up and it will become 100 kilometer per hour. Now distance between both the trains at 4 p.m. is 60 kilometer. Yes, because they are at the respective stations. Now when both the trains meet, the distance between them will become 0 kilometer. So total distance that both the trains have to cover is 60 kilometers. Alright, so we need to find the time taken by both trains to cover 60 kilometer combined. Okay, so what is the formula for finding the time? Time is equal to distance upon speed. Okay, so we know the distance, which is 60 kilometers. We know the speed, which is relative speed, okay, which is 100 kilometer per hour. So we get 0.6 hours. So 0.6 hours in terms of minutes will be 0.6 into 60, which becomes 36 minutes after 4 p.m. That is after they start. So it becomes 4:36 p.m. Option B is the correct option. 4:36 p.m. is the correct answer. All right. So now we'll take a look at another example. Two trains are moving in the same direction at 65 km per hour and 45 km per hour. Okay, in the same direction. Now the problem is changed. They are moving in the same direction, not opposite direction, but same direction. The faster train crosses a man sitting in the slower train in 18 seconds. The length of the faster train is A, 120 meters, B, 180 meters, C, 100 meters, and D, 145 meters. So as I had told you, I'm going to tell you my own shortcut trick for this. First, we'll solve it with the normal method. Then I'll tell you my shortcut method, how to solve this problem. Okay. Now, first we'll look at what is the data given to us. We are given the speed of the faster train, which is 65 km per hour. Speed of the slower train is 45 km per hour. So relative speed of the faster train with the slower train will be 65 minus 45. Remember, this is minus. Why? Because both the trains are moving in the same direction. So the speed of the faster train minus the speed of the slower train. That's how we get it. So the relative speed will be 20 km per hour. Okay. Now time taken to pass the man is given to us as 18 seconds. Okay. So this is the data that is given to us. 18 seconds is the time taken. Now relative speed is 20 km per hour and time given to us is in seconds. So what do? We convert this speed into meters per second. How do we do it? 20 into 5 by 18, which gets 5.56 meters per second. Now we have to find the length of the faster train, that is equal to the distance traveled. Okay, what is the formula for distance? Distance is equal to speed into time. Distance is equal to 18 seconds. Distance is equal to speed into time. So speed is 18 seconds and time is 5.56. Speed is equal to 5.56 meters per second and time is equal to 18 seconds. Okay, when we multiply, we get 100 meters. So option C is the correct answer, which is 100 meters. Now this, if you try to solve with this normal method, you'll require approximately around 2 to 3 minutes to solve this problem. But I'm going to tell you a method in which you can solve this in 1 minute or so. So just look at the problem. Okay, when you look at the problem, two trains are moving the same direction at 65 km per hour, 45 km per hour. Without writing it on the paper also, you can do the math in your mind. 65 minus 45, in your mind you can do, the relative speed will be 20 km per hour because they are moving the same direction. So first data you got over there only. Second data is given to us is that the faster train crosses a man sitting in the slower train at 18 seconds. Now take a look at this. This is 18 seconds. Okay. So does this ring any specific number in your mind? 18 is similar to 5 by 18 of our formula. Remember? So you don't have to solve the fractions. You can just keep the fraction while converting the speed. Okay. So what we can do, shortcut technique is over here. instead of converting the relative speed over here, what you can do is just keep this as 20 into 5 by 18 as 100 upon 18. Okay, 100 upon 18 is the relative speed, and when you multiply speed and time, instead of this 5.56 meters per second, you have 100 upon 18 into 18 seconds. So 18 cancels, you directly get the 100 meters. So this is the shortcut technique I am talking about. Just by looking at the options, you will come to know which one will be the closest one. 100 meters is the one which will be easiest one or most closest one to the correct answer, and you can just confirm it on the paper without converting the relative speed. Directly just multiply and see. Okay, keep the fraction, it will help you to do this problem or solve this problem faster. So that's it for today, guys. If you have any doubt, feel free to ask them in the comment section below. Guys, these problems are very much useful, or these techniques are very much useful while you are solving problems in CAT, ZAT or bank exams. So if you have any doubts or you want me to make videos on any topics for those exams, feel free to ask them in the comment section below. Make sure you subscribe, like this video, share this video with your friends. Thank you.